Good morning, children. Today we are going to start chapter number 6, that is adjectives, or we can call them describing words. Words that describe the quality of a person, animal, place, or thing are called adjectives. Or we can say adjectives tell us more about person, place, animal, or thing. An adjective is a word used to describe a noun or a pronoun. For example, tall man, big hospital, small cub, and brown table. So words tall, big, small, and brown, they describe them. So they are called describing words. So what did we learn? Words that describe the quality of a person, animal, place, or things are called adjectives. Words used for numbers, colors, size, and shape are also called adjectives. For example, smart boy, small ant, empty box, full box, red car, blue butterfly, big elephant, round table, one hen and two chicks. So we saw words used to describe quality, that is smart boy, color red car, size big elephant, shape round table, numbers one hen, two chicks are all adjectives. Adjectives also describes how someone or something looks, tastes, feels, smells, or sounds like. Let's see some example of these. Beautiful girl. Beautiful describes the looks of the girl. Salty chips. Salty describes the taste of the chips. Soft pillow. Soft describes the feel of the pillow. Fresh fragrance. Fresh describes the fragrance of the perfume. Loud music. Loud describes the sound of the music. Look at the picture and tell me where is the adjective? An angry man. Angry is adjective because it describes the feeling of this man. A happy person. Happy is the adjective. It is green. Now here, green tells us the color of the grass. A wide road. Now where is the adjective here? Word wide. An orange pen. It tells us about color orange. He is fat. Fat is adjective. It tells us about look. So children, what did we learn today? An adjective is a word used to describe a noun or a pronoun. And remember, adjective mostly comes before a noun. Today we are going to do exercise A and B on page number 19 and exercise C on page number 20 will be your prep work. I will tell you what you have to do in exercise C. So let's do exercise A and B now. Are you all ready with your textbook? Let's open page number 19. Exercise A, underline the appropriate adjectives in the following sentences. Now here, children, can you see the sentences? And in each one of them, there are two words given in the brackets. You have to choose the correct adjective that fits the sentence. Let's do number one. The sun is round oval. Now what will come here? Yes, the sun is round. So let's underline. Number two, everyone likes to sleep on a soft, hard bed. Now what kind of bed you like to sleep on? Soft, isn't it? So let's underline soft. Number three, mummy gave me a sweet sour chocolate. Now what kind of chocolate you like? Sweet, isn't it? Do you like sour chocolate? No. So let's underline sweet. Number four, I saw some white green clouds. Now what kind of clouds you saw? Can it be green clouds? No. So white clouds, underline white. Number five, the athlete was happy, sad when he won the race. Now who is an athlete? A person who is very good at sports activities or exercises. So here, if you won something, will you be happy or sad? Yes, you will be happy. So let's underline. Number six, I burnt my hand on the hot cold stove. Now children, do you burn yourself when you touch something cold? No. So what adjective will come here? Hot. Number seven, grandfather bought some ripe raw apples for me. Now what kind of fruits you like to eat? Ripe or raw? Yes, you like ripe, isn't it? Because ripe fruits are more sweet and soft. So let's underline ripe. Number eight, children were not allowed to go to the shallow, deep end of the swimming pool. Now small children are not allowed to go to which part of the swimming pool? Deep part, isn't it? So let's underline deep. Let's do exercise B. On the same page, complete the crossword with the opposites of the given adjectives. Now children, can you see these adjectives given on the left hand side? You have to find out the opposite of them and write them in the crossword given on the right hand side. Now let me tell you what is across and what is down. Can you see these sleeping lines, sleeping blocks? They are all across, and the standing ones are all down. So let's do, we will do the first one, number three, high. Now what is opposite of high? Low. And what is the spelling of low? L-O-W. So where will you write low? Here. Can you see this number three written here? So three, you will write here next to three. Let's do it. Low. Next is number four, across. So where will you write four across? Here. It is tall. What is opposite of tall? Short. And spelling is S-H-O-R-T. Let's do the next one. Number six is wet. What is the opposite of wet? Dry. And where will it come here? Here. So come on, let's write dry. Now we will go to the downwards. Number one, can you see it here? Number one, smooth. Now what is the opposite of smooth, rough. So where will you write rough? Here. Now here already O and H written for you. So you will write the spelling R-O-U-G-H. Now let's do number 2. Where will number 2 go? Here. What is it? Heavy. What is the opposite of heavy? Light. So let's write light here. L-I-G-H-T. Then we have number 4. Where will number 4 here? Find out number 4. Yes, here. Happy. What is the opposite of happy? Sad. So let's write sad here. S-A-D. Sad. And the last one, number 5, new. What is the opposite of new? Old. You will write here. 5 down. Old. You could, all of you could do it. Great. Now let's turn the page. On the next page, exercise C will be your home task. Now what you have to do here, draw the following as specified. Great, you must be happy. You have to draw. So let's see what you have to draw. In the first box, you have to draw a pair of blue shoes. Now you are going to draw 2 shoes. And you will color them blue because it's written here, blue shoes. That means you will draw how many shoes? 2. Similar ones. Okay. And when something which is 2 and similar, it is called a pair. And in the next box, you have to draw a painted face. Now, what is painted face? You have to draw a face. You can draw any face, say of a cartoon or a boy or a girl, and you have to paint it. That means you have to color it. So these 2 drawings you will do it at home. In the next class, we will do the other exercises about adjectives. Till then, enjoy yourself. Goodbye. And have a great day.